वेलकम फ्रेंड्स टू मिंद्रा ऑटो प्रोजेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन. एज इट इज़ वी हैव डिसाइडेड टू टेक अप सर्टन क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर फेस्ड बाय आवर वेरियस व्यूअर्स ऑन यूट्यूब चैनल एंड ब्लॉग एंड द वेबसाइट एंड ऑल दैट. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट अ क्वेश्चन व्हिच वाज रेज्ड बाय अ व्यूअर अबाउट हाउ टू गेट एन ISI फॉर बॉटल्ड वाटर. ओके, सो एज यू आर सीइंग द वाटर व्हिच आई एम टेकिंग राइट नाउ, this was consumed from a bottle, okay, the domestic fridge bottle. So actually, if you are just drinking like that, you don't need an ISI, right, for this. Actually, the water, drinking water, if you are having some certain, you know, drinking water, it should also conform to standards. So who decides the standards, you know? So there is an institute called BIS. So what is BIS? So BIS is basically Bureau of Indian Standards. So it gives, you know, standards to various products, not just water. So the products which are in interest of people, which have some common standardization. So BIS issues all the products the ISI number. They allot them the ISI numbers. So water also should qualify to the ISI number. So as I told you, when you are doing a business of selling water, okay, so then the whole thing comes into picture. Okay. I'll show you now another bottle, which, you know, in this case you will be, if you can see this, you know, this is packaged drinking water. So this packaged drinking water, because this company Schweppes, they are selling this water. So they are selling, you know, you can see some ISI number here. So in this case, you will need an ISI number if you are doing a business of selling water. So now again, you know, there are two kinds of waters which are available. One is the packaged drinking water and one is mineral water. So there is a difference between mineral and packaged drinking water. There is another video, maybe you can see that. The point is how to get an ISI number if you decide to go for that. So to get an ISI number, you have to apply to the BIS and you know, you get the ISI number, but it is not as straight as you think like. So they have some standards laid up. So your water should conform to that standards. Okay, so the simple thing is you should establish a plant first. Then you have to follow the procedures of the BIS which have been laid up. So these procedures to be followed, it needs some laboratories, in-house laboratory setup, and you need to maintain some standards. There are some reports to be maintained daily, monthly, weekly. Okay, so these needs to be satisfied, then you get the ISI number kind of thing. And how much does it cost? You know, BIS cost is like 1,28,000 rupees per annum. So every year you need to renew it. How long it takes to a BIS getting an ISI number? So roughly, depending upon the availability of the personnel which the ISI has got. So after you set up a plant, you take typically 1 month to 3 months. Okay, and how fast you can get it? I mean, the better you set up a plant, okay, so better you get an ISI number. Okay, so a tip here is that you should follow the guidelines set up by the ISI perfectly. Because every year they can, you have to renew it, number one. So next year, who will be the person who will be coming to you? You don't know that, okay? So you should follow the standards. And as a marketing concern and post-COVID, it is very important to follow the hygiene standards. And if you follow the hygiene standards, you can also be a preferred brand in front of people who are going to buy the water from you, maybe the distributors or the consumers, okay? And you know, any other questions if you have about ISI, you do ask us. And before closing this video, don't forget to subscribe to the video. And there is a description given in the description about the website. You can also subscribe to our newsletter and press the bell icon next to the subscribe, so you will not lose a single notification. Thank you. I'm Soumitra Gottekar from Mineral Water Project Information.